polycystic ovarian syndrome, PCOS, also known as PCOD, polycystic ovarian disease. We are going to discuss the causes of polycystic ovarian disease. There are three main causes of PCOD, polycystic ovarian disease. Have you had the ultrasound scan and the doctor has told you, your doctor has told you that you have PCOS, that is polycystic ovarian disease, and you are asking yourself, what are the causes of polycystic ovarian disease? Stay with me in this video today. We are going to learn everything in this video lesson about polycystic ovarian disease causes. Gerald Massa, the health educator, and the names of the channel. Remember to subscribe so that you do not miss new videos we release every day about fertility and reproductive health. Polycystic ovarian disease. When we are discussing about polycystic ovarian disease, we should pay close attention to the three main causes. The first cause of polycystic ovarian disease is that it is actually brought about by a hormonal imbalance. If at all your hormones are not balancing, then it means that you could actually end up with what you call polycystic ovarian disease. The three steps to help you get pregnant, even if you have PCOS, even if you have polycystic ovarian disease. How can you get pregnant? Very fast, even if you have polycystic ovarian disease. Gerald Massa, the health educator, are the names of the channel, and I welcome you, my friend. If it's your first time on our channel, remember to subscribe so that you do not miss new videos we release every day. What are those key steps you can take to get pregnant even if you have polycystic ovarian syndrome? Number one, you are actually supposed to lose weight. If you are overweight, you are a lady, you are trying to get pregnant, things are not working out, you've gone to hospital, you've done the pelvic or gynecologic scan, you've done the ultrasound scan, and your doctor has told you that you have polycystic ovarian syndrome, also known as PCOS, and you are asking yourself, what should you do? If you are overweight, look at losing weight. Now, if you would like to lose weight, there are many remedies you can actually take up. For example, if you do not have peptic ulcer disease, you can consider beginning on lemon. You take one lemon, mix with some ginger, and then also add some little garlic, and then add 2 cups of water, boil, and then take 1 cup every day for 30 days. But remember, this combination works very well for you if you do not have peptic ulcer disease. If you have peptic ulcers, then first talk to your doctor, who will advise you on which best plans you need to do to lose weight. But the first key step you need to take if you have polycystic ovarian disease, PCOS, and you are looking at getting pregnant, you would like to get pregnant, please lose weight. The next step, the next key thing you need to do for you to get pregnant, even if you have polycystic ovarian syndrome, is you should actually consider beginning on medications. Your doctor will advise you on which medications you are supposed to begin on immediately. But most likely, because in women with polycystic ovarian syndrome, there's always a high level, or there's always an increase of the male hormone known as testosterone. So the drugs that will be prescribed for you or for your condition, most likely they are going to be anti-androgens, or they are going to be drugs that will help to lower the male hormone, because it is a known fact that if at all a woman has PCOS, chances are her hormones, the male hormones, that is the testosterone levels, are very high. So your doctor will prescribe you a drug to stabilize or to normalize your male hormone levels in a woman. The next step for you to take if you would like to get pregnant very fast is you should work on your diet. Make sure that you have or you eat foods that are rich in green leafy vegetables that are rich in vitamins. But you should consider green leafy vegetables. You should consider more organic foods. Avoid processed foods. Avoid or reduce sugars. Reduce carbohydrates. These are the three key steps for you to take if you would like to get pregnant faster. Remember to subscribe to our channel so that you do not miss any new videos we upload on this channel. And remember to support our channel, remember to support our work by going to the link below this video. Again, we shall be very, very humbled. Thank you. Let me see you in my next video tomorrow. And remember, on this channel, we do create awareness about fertility and reproductive health. God bless and bye-bye. In this video today, we are going to discuss the symptoms of polycystic ovarian syndrome. Have you been asking yourself, what are the symptoms of polycystic ovarian syndrome? In this video, we are going to discuss everything about polycystic ovarian syndrome. So without further ado, Gerald Massa, the health educator, and the names of the channel you are on, I welcome you. If it's your first time on our channel, on this channel, we do create awareness about fertility and reproductive health. Polycystic ovarian syndrome is our topic for today. What are the symptoms of polycystic ovarian syndrome? The first symptom you are most likely going to see is one of irregular periods. When you are experiencing irregular periods, you are supposed to see your periods this month, maybe today, but you've not seen your periods. 2 weeks pass by, you have not yet again seen your periods. This could actually be an indicator that there's something happening in your system. It could be a sign of polycystic ovarian syndrome. But remember, there are many other causes of irregular periods. But if you experience irregular periods, it could be among the signs that you could actually be developing what we call polycystic ovarian syndrome. Next symptom for polycystic ovarian syndrome is that there's going to be difficulties getting pregnant. Remember, we've said that you could begin developing irregular periods. If the periods are irregular, then it means that you may actually find it difficult to track your most fertile days because the periods are irregular. So it brings us to the next point of difficulties getting pregnant. You may try to get pregnant and things are not working out well. This could be that you need to take time to track your menstrual cycle, to track your safe days and your danger days. So difficulties getting pregnant is our next sign of polycystic ovarian syndrome. Next sign of polycystic ovarian syndrome is there's going to be what you call excessive hair loss. Most doctors call this alopecia. If you are experiencing hair loss at a very high rate, then this could actually be a sign that you are actually having polycystic ovarian syndrome. Remember, there are many other causes of hair loss. For example, if you have hormonal imbalances or hormonal changes, high estrogen levels, you could actually also experience hair loss. But in this case, we are discussing polycystic ovarian syndrome. If you are experiencing hair loss, you have irregular periods, you are having difficulties getting pregnant, this could actually be a sign that you could actually be having what you call polycystic ovarian syndrome. The next symptom we are going to discuss about is acne. In most cases, you may actually begin developing pimples or lumps of oily skin. And this could actually also be an indicator that you could be having what you call polycystic ovarian syndrome. The next symptom for polycystic ovarian syndrome is rapid weight gain. You may actually begin putting on weight, you as a woman, and you may ask yourself, why are you putting on too much weight? Why are you having difficulties getting pregnant? Why are you having irregular menses? And why are you losing your hair at a very fast rate? It is high time you did checkups for polycystic ovarian syndrome. What are the checkups for polycystic ovarian syndrome? I will discuss more in our next video, but in a nutshell, the first test for polycystic ovarian syndrome is what we call a pelvic
YouTube channel ya fe era webanga wilina kuru resource njiga pese ya radio subscribing waleme okumisinga videos bulilu njiga akadago weja kukula wa videos zetuteka yo bulikana kuso webanga awadoli kulito urumi eno wansi wansinga mundira na hati nga urumi kuna weja mwe uli kutambula ati nishira ni periodo zita msukumanga tezidi kutelida urumji nyo nga ati ulimichara weja kule ila dalanti wandieta kisa okubanga wekelejiwa wino kubanga ugenda mtuwalido ndeni dokita uo na kula check-ups na zula kuruachi ulikuli na embele eno wabotu sa mtuwalido dokita uo sile visinga aja kusaba yo test jetuise pelvic ultrasound scan and then scan yinu eja kubanga iso ulikulanga exactly kuruachi ulikuli okulumi wabotu scan yinu eja kubilaga ensekezo zilizitia ande imechilaga eja kubilaga nabana yunga nyo ilietia etelede watetelede ande lastly eno scan eja kubilaga ama jiko galigatia tila ni master health educator gemanya akachano eda uyumbile kubango laba videos titikayo bulikanako tuligena mwana sumante singa doktor azura nti doktor wakula scan deni mazura nti wadu inamuko kubuzivu wakubango maybe walina ekizimba. Ekizimba kino tukiyise lymphoma oba fibroid. Ojja kwesanga nti wandyetaaga obujjanjabi naye nga tonafuna bujjanjabi bwa kizimba, kiba kirungi nnyo n'osooka n'okebejibwa obulungi okuzuula ekizimba kino kyava ku ki. Kyandiba nga kyava ku hormones ezitabalansinga obulungi. Hormones zinjogerako ziri bbiri. Hormone esooka yeno gye tuyise estrogen, eyokubiri gye tuyise progesterone. So bino byonna dokita basobola obikola n'azuula obuzibuva ku ki then n'afujjanjaba bulungi. Olwo kubeera omusomo gwaffe guno ogwa leero kakola buli video.
Mukwano gwange mu video eyasembayo twayogera ku kirwadde kye tuyise blighted ovum naye ate mubanga badde olina ekibuuzo kyonna kyonna ekikwata ku blighted ovum niki bye twayogerako osobola okibuuza. First of all, blighted ovum twagamba nti kaba kasawo ng'ate tekali mu lubuto kabeera empty muzungu kye tuyita an empty gestation sac. Kano kasawo ebiseera ebisinga okuzuula nti omuntu alina blighted ovum alina okumakinga sure nti akola scan. Scan tuziyita pelvic ultrasound scan oba esobola okulaga oba kasawo mwekali oba tekaliimu. So byonna byonna nga tubitiiridde oba okusobola okwebuuza nti naye obuzuulibwa nti olina blighted ovum kiki oba ogenda okukola. Ekisookerwako kiri nti olina okusooka n'omanya nti blighted ovum sikwaba kireese kijjaguzi era mu bakyala kikumi mubamu bakyala nga bataano bokkabooka ababeera n'ekyo ekirwadde. So oba osobola okuba ng'okwatagana ne dokitabo n'akuteeka ku ddagala.